I am from sand, from Africa's ivory residue in an hourglass, shifting context, fertile ground and a body that flows and bends along curves in the tapestry of a land not promised. From a watershed of exploits that carved out my humanness, leaving parts of me in the valley while the universe stood by idly. From along the shore's edge where hope met purpose. I am from water, a transformation of consciousness over the Atlantic, from the bowels of generations overboard, in a journey of movement across one long voyage. From the turbulence between stones that have shaped the course of time, I am strange fruit. Born in tears, bodies, and violence, strewn throughout these United States, and now again. While some posit whether my life matters, really? But I am certain ancestors who sojourned for me freed me forever, so I might be from Kenwood, from a keeper of bees, from family reunions in the Texas heat, Wharton, Edna, Louise, where flies gather like cousins, from chitlins, fried chicken, cornbread, collards, and mustard greens on New Year's Day, sweet potato pie, from a two-parent home with its own problems, from my divorce and closed fists that struck me but did not kill me, from Sunday service, 11 a.m., that saved me, and faith that rebuilds me brick by brick, from strength conveyed from prior ages. I am alive. Thank you. So my name is Ari, a name for my grandmother. And first I want to just say thank you to my professor, Dr. Octavio Quintanilla, for this opportunity, to Gemini Inc. And I want you guys to know that that is called a bio point. And so I had the opportunity, along with some very interesting and hardworking co-teachers, this last semester to be a writer in community, where we taught third through fifth graders, Clint Taylor and Erica Della Rosa and myself, to do bio points. So it was so much fun that I decided I would do one too. So the next point I'd like to do for you is a result of a philosophy class. Let me just say this. I crashed a Gemini Inc. publishing party a couple of years ago, 2-3 years ago, because I felt like I was just supposed to be there. And I was reading you guys' website and I saw it, so I just showed up. And that's where I learned about the MFA party. I'm a little nervous. Excuse me. That's where I learned about the degree. And so it had me written all over it. And so I have been at the lake in that program. I am enjoying it. It is amazing. My next point is a result of a philosophy class. that is a part of that program where we talked a lot about social justice and from the perspective of some of the great philosophers, and we use what those philosophers had to say about social justice and the different types of social justice as a backdrop for our discussions about current events. So this poem is called Asylum. Desperation suffers no retreat. When whispers above dawn present themselves as pleas for civility, for a chance to live whole, they gather in line to wait their turn at democracy. Finding none, suffer apathy. Turned up palms desire a wall between themselves and fear. Finding none, mothers and fathers are separated from their babies who are neglected in systems of hate without number. When hardened hearts harbor indifference, muted mouths will not speak. They are silent to oppression. When humans seek recourse, finding none, they retire promise, but not hope. Even as emptiness is measured in pain's single refrain of loss, a running narrative told in brown bodies. Thank you. This next poem is called Lightning is Doing Its Limber Dance. This is, my mom used to say that. And anytime there was a storm, and she had a lot of really cool, wise things to say, and these old sayings, so this kind of stuck with me, and I did a poem about it, wrote a poem about it. Lightning is doing its limber dance, standing on its many hands with spiny arms outstretched, elongated extremities extended, scratching the surface of the earth with flash was here. The birth of devastation may be near as heated breath expands, then diminishes quickly. The night awaits its fate while chance recreates opportunity for close encounters of the unwelcome kind. Electrical enigmas tap, tango, and pirouette. Meteorological promise, energy trades place with more energy, and mind attempts gain over matter. A symphony of clatter strikes up, an accompany of exploding air singing back up. Its melody warns a change in the atmosphere. We are drawn to this ballet in a frightening sort of way, for its portrayal of purpose separates the sky. With laser-like intent, it is nimble and graceful, intrusive yet elusive, concocting strings of dazzling compositions that are persuasive, demanding we pay attention and check our pulse. Thank you. This has been such an amazing journey for me, being a part of this program. It was being a writer, being a poet is what I always wanted to be and always thought I was. And then I thought maybe it's a good idea to honor my craft and go learn how to do it. So I went to school, and my very first class in this amazing program was a literature in London, and we actually went to London. I was so excited. It was my first time across the pond, they say. And this poem is a result of an encounter I had in London. It's called Man in Wheelchair in Stratford Pub. I met a man who loved me today. I heard him say, come here, come here. You're quite beautiful, aren't you? You've made an old man happy. So I placed my arms around his shoulders to love him back. That's it. So I'd like to end with something on a light note. And I hope you'll enjoy it. What can you do? What can you say? Yeah, when you find love slipping away. If it's sweetness today, then it's sweet I'm gonna be. I'll try anything I can just to bring him back to me. Or is it house hopping, I should have inquired, being an informed buyer. Does a man come with this floor plan? You see, my generations will need a firm foundation on which to grow. Will the realtor forego the commission to provide a male for the model I'm dishing earnest money out on? I realize I can do it on my own, but I prefer a mister in my master. Now, when it's time I'm killing, who'll do the grilling, you know, when we're chilling? Who'll take care of the yard and me? Hold me, console me, cajole me into activity when empty days make lonely nights, cause sleeping double, single in a double bed. Well, Barbara Mandrell said that just ain't right. In this space designed for him and me, when the TV is on till all hours of the dawn, who's gonna rock me to sleep, give me a piece of his soul to keep, need me to get along, miss me when I'm gone, remember me like his favorite song, cause ain't no woman like the one he's got. Say, yeah, baby, you're right. When he knows I'm dead wrong, rub my feet when the day's been long, pardon me. But shouldn't there be a mister in this master? Certainly I can make my way through every day, handling the business of each moment. I am vanilla, latte, caramel, dark chocolate, candy, solving the world's ills in high heels, paying the bills and turning heads, managing the whatevers of the daily grind and endeavor to succeed, but need one true love to go through life with. Women slip, that's all good. I got my freedom leaving the womb. And no discontent can prevent my ascent or level of playing field for me. There is no equity in being alone. Where's the man in my destiny? Yes, I bought some land. I put a house on it. Now Prince Charming needs to come on and warm it. Put a little something on it. Doggone it. I need a mister for my master. Now, not just any old master, a mister will suffice. The price I've paid for this property should net me something better than a Mac Daddy, Cat Daddy, Play Daddy. I don't need a piece of man, one who's already got full hands trying to please one lover, maybe more. That kind of man can keep on moving right out the door. I am well able to take care of the constants. That's the way I'm wired, the way we're wired. It's in the contingencies I desire the vim and vigor of a good man. 100% committed, in it to win it. Tall he stands, not arrogant, but confident in his strength. So much so he sometimes allows me to see his vulnerability. Because he trusts me and loves me like God loves the church. Yes, that's the man for me. Just thinking about him makes my heart beat a little faster. And if that man is you, then come on, let's call the pastor. And you can be the mister in my master. Thank you very much.